These days, many people lead an inactive lifestyle. What has been the role of movement and sports throughout history? Around 600 BC, active living and sports were already used to keep the body healthy. Sushruta, an Indian surgeon, was the first recorded physician to prescribe moderate daily exercise. Also, Hippocrates said 2,370 years ago that a walk is a man's best medicine. He was the most influential advocate of lifestyle as medicine. But the original purpose of movement and sports, health, was compromised by a second purpose, winning. Winning in sports and winning in battle. Homo sapiens never truly returned to that original health purpose until now. Wrestling is one of the oldest forms of sports. It is depicted in 15,000-year-old cave drawings in France. And early Egyptian and Babylonian reliefs show techniques still used today. Most of the time, we did sports to get fit and strong for war, as gladiators, or to perform well in sports tournaments like the Olympics, and not specifically for our health and well-being. In the Middle Ages, there was hardly any attention to the value of active lifestyles or sports apart from training for knights tournaments and war. The average life expectancy back then was 40, so the importance of maintaining a healthy and fit body was not all that high. Around 1800, sports participation is growing a little, but mainly as a part of therapy. Over the course of the 19th century, however, we see an increase in public sports. Team sports like rugby, football, cricket, and baseball become increasingly popular. There's competitive swimming, rowing, and tennis. Another turning point for sports were the first modern Olympic Games, which were held in April 1896 in Athens, Greece, with athletes from 14 countries participating. The 19th century also saw some famous advocates for physical exercise, like the American president Theodore Roosevelt. He suffered from severe asthma as a child, which he largely overcame by a program of gymnastics and weightlifting. Another famous sports advocate was Eugen Sandow, a German strongman who became the founder of modern fitness. Between 1860 and 1900, sports was integrated in public schools with the introduction of gymnastics. Gymnastics was almost simultaneously developed in different European countries. For physical education, both the German and Swedish gymnastics systems were the most influential. In Germany, Friedrich Ludwig Jahn started the Turnverein movement. The German system used large fixed equipment, vaulting, and marching. In Sweden, Per Henrik Ling invented light gymnastics that used no apparatus and which consisted of calisthenics and exercises. At the start of the 20th century, sports are still not being developed as a prevention activity to support good health. At this point in time, they're still mostly competitive and recreational activities. In Europe, cycling and soccer are the most popular. Sports are gaining popularity because soldiers are introduced to different kinds of sports during their military service. After World War II, the 8-hour working day became the norm, which led to the introduction of all kinds of sports clubs that offered the opportunity to exercise during the weekend. Sports turned more and more into a recreational pastime. After World War II, sports were also permanently introduced at schools, which meant that sports were offered and taught at a young age. Sports clubs started to thrive. The connection between health and sports had a major breakthrough due to research by Dr. Cooper in 1968. He was the founder of aerobics. His research proved that cardiovascular or aerobic training had a positive impact on the prevention of heart and vascular disease. The importance of strength training to prevent, for instance, sarcopenia was not widely introduced by the World Health Organization until 2009, and it was not incorporated into the exercise guidelines of most countries until 2015. Actually, we could argue that routine exercise for good health has not been well known and scientifically validated until the last 5 to 10 years. The result is that over the last 100 years, many generations have been raised with little or no knowledge of the importance of exercise for good health. This leads to the fact that over 90% of European population has a lack of health literacy or knowledge about health and health skills. It will take an awareness change to close this gap.